Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the causes, clinical presentation and management of the bronchial obstruction. So let's start with the causes. The common causes of bronchial obstruction are tumors, enlarged tracheobronchial lymph nodes, inhaled foreign bodies, bronchial casts or plugs, infective expectoration. Rare causes, bronchial carcinoma, bronchial adenoma, malignant tuberculosis, impisate mucus, blood clots, collection of mucus or mucopus in the bronchus, congenital bronchial atresia, post tuberculosis bronchial stricture, aortic aneurysm, giant left atrium, pericardial effusions. Now what will be the clinical presentation? The clinical manifestation of bronchial obstruction depends on the following: whether the obstruction is complete or partial, presence or absence of secondary infection, effect on pulmonary function, and cause of the obstruction. Now the clinical feature related to the degree of obstruction. If there is a complete obstruction, air distal to the obstruction is absorbed, alveolar space close and the affected lung tissue becomes collapsed and solidified. Physical signs are mediastinal shift to the side of the collapse, dull percussion note and absence or diminished breath sounds. Radiological features includes mediastinal shift to the same side, elevation of the diaphragm on the same side, and dense pulmonary opacity. If the collapse involved a small portion of lung, mediastinal displacement and abnormal physical signs may be absent, but a characteristic opacity will be seen on the radiograph. Partial obstruction. In cases of partial obstruction, results in less resistance to the airflow during inspiration and during expiration. The difference in the airflow resistance is accentuated by the coughing. The end result in air trapping distal to the obstruction, leading to over distension of the part of the lung distal to the obstruction, that is called as obstructive emphysema. Percussion note over such a lesion is hyper resonant and air breath sound are diminished. Radiological examination show hyper translucency of the affected part of the lung. Clinical features related to secondary infection. Secondary bacterial infection of the lung distal to the obstruction is common. This is usually of low virulence, but in some cases pulmonary suppuration and lung abscess follow. Can present with recurrent pneumonia in the same segments or lobes. Clinical features related to the impaired pulmonary functions are: symptoms usually follow the obstruction of the main or lobar bronchus. Sudden occlusion can result in severe breathlessness and hypoxemia. Then clinical features related to the cause of the obstruction are: if there is tumor, bronchial carcinoma produces pulmonary collapse at an early stage. Secondary bacterial infection and emphysema are common. Bronchial adenoma grows less rapidly and hence complete the obstruction and pulmonary collapse are late features. Obstructive emphysema may be seen in early stage of partial bronchial obstruction. In cases of enlarged tracheobronchial lymph nodes may compress or invade the bronchial wall. Clinical manifestation are similar to those seen in the tumors, and commonest cause is the bronchial carcinoma, but less common cause are tuberculosis, Hodgkin's lymphoma and other lymphomas. Then foreign bodies. Inhaled foreign bodies usually get lodged in the right main, intermediate or lower lobe bronchus. Common foreign body inhaled are nuts, peas, beans, small pieces of toys, articles. Of food and fragments of tooth during dental extraction under general anesthesia. Initial presentation is either as obstructive emphysema or lobar collapse with persistent low pitched ronchus, that is fixed ronchus. Later, there is development of suppurative pneumonia in the collapsed lobe, manifested as high fever, cough with prevalent expectoration, pleural pain, pleura, rub, and signs of either collapse or consolidation. Radiological examination may reveal obstructive emphysema or collapse or consolidation. Then bronchial casts or plugs. Mucus plugs cause bronchial obstruction in the patient with asthma or pulmonary eosinophilia. Secondary bacterial infection of the collapsed lung may occur. Blood clots produce bronchial obstruction following severe hemoptysis. Then there are retained secretion, bronchial obstruction by retained mucus or mucopus occur in patient who are unable to cough effectively for some reason. Secondary bacterial infection is common and occurs early. What are the management strategies? Then identification of the cause by chest radiograph, bronchoscopy examination and biopsy. Bronchoscopic removal of the foreign bodies, bronchial cast, plugs and secretion. Treatment of the underlying cause is the main management of the bronchial obstruction. So this was all about bronchial obstruction, and here the topic of bronchial obstruction comes to an end.